Hello, everybody. So I'm going to talk about traffic because I think we are all aware of the amount of stress and interpersonal stress in traffic. And it's surprising to see how often people, and sometimes very kind people, seem to have a personality shift as soon as they sit in a car. And it's not that they become wiser or kinder or more compassionate. And somehow this is very sad. And I think if we want to make this world a better place, we all need to take radical responsibility for the way how we live our lives. And we may want to offer our kindness rather than our judgments to the world and to ourselves. So I have a question. Who has not been in a hurry in the last 7 days? So the feeling of, I'm here, but I already want to be there. So just raise a hand. You have not been in a hurry. Okay, we have 3, 4 people. 5, interesting. Who has not been in a hurry in the last 3 days? More people? How about today, Saturday? Okay, still not so many. So we all know the experience of being in a hurry. Yes. Now, who can honestly say, by almost hurrying every day, my life is more fulfilling and I'm happier? Raise your hands. It's an important question because we all hurry and nobody says it makes him happier. And if you still believe it does, you can ask yourself when you're in a hurry, how kind are you to your children? Or how kind are you to the other travelers on the road? Or how kind are you to yourself? And does it really make a difference? If you hurry for 30 minutes, how many minutes do you win? 2? 3? And how many minutes do you need to bring your stress levels down again? Probably 5 or 10. So now imagine you're driving a car and you're already late, and let's suppose that being on time is a value for you. It's not a value for everybody. And the meeting already started, so you are in a hurry. And here you are, you're driving, and just in front of you, the light is turning red. You still wanted to accelerate to get through, but the car in front of you stops. So here you are. So what is your experience? Just check for yourself. Probably some frustration, irritation. We may become very judgmental or even angry. I think we all know the experience of at least some irritation in front of a red light. Now, anyone ever noticed that by allowing yourself to get irritated, the light is turning green? It's an important question. Because what do you want? Do you want to experience peacefulness or restlessness? I think, well, some people may be addicted to certain level of restlessness, but most of us want to experience at least some peace. But if you allow yourself to get irritated in front of the red light, what do you create? I think we all know the answer is obvious. And it doesn't make sense because it doesn't make any difference. And we all do it. I don't think we need to drive a long time before we see it happening. And we shouldn't judge ourselves. Because actually it's not really we doing it, it's our brain doing it. We call it the old brain. The old brain which is just ready to scan the environment and to see if there's a threat. And as soon as a threat is being detected, the old brain activates a fight response. Ready for survival. Your whole body is being prepared. And this was, or is still very important when really your life may be at stake. But the problem is that we react in such a way only when we see a red light or when somebody is not driving the way we want them to drive. So that means we can easily start to create a life full of restlessness. So I think we cannot forget we have a new brain as well. New brain where you have warmth and compassion and understanding, tenderness are located. And sometimes when we drive a car, we forget we have a new brain. And that also happens when we have these deadlines, when we want to achieve a lot of things under time pressure. And unfortunately, as a society, we seem to be under time pressure all the time. And we are being dominated by doing modes. And we are not able to simply take time to feel that we are alive and that we breathe, the same air, that we are connected, and that we could be very grateful to one another because we all contribute to the gifts of this world. Like, just think about all the people who contributed to make this building, all the people who contributed to make this happen. And so we could also care for each other, even when we drive a car. So, what to do? You may know these wonderful mindful exercises that allow you to approach a red light not so much with the oh no attitude, but rather with the oh yes attitude, a chance to bring my stress levels down. So we can simply bring the awareness to the breath, we let go of all these stressful thoughts, and we can invite a smile, gentle smile, just lifting the corners of your mouth. Sometimes people tell me, yes, but I'm not happy, and I shouldn't smile. Then I ask them, do you also need a reason to look sad? Then we don't need a reason. But interesting enough, by simply lifting the corners of your mouth, research has shown that we feel a little happier. And we are more open for the positive things in life. So also when you're driving and you feel very stressed, you can simply invite your inner smile. And if it's very difficult, because sometimes you're attached to this judgmental mindset, what may be helpful as well is just taking a pen and putting it in your mouth like this. It has been shown that by just putting your pen like this in the mouth, you can even try, if you have a pen you want, can try now. Just after 10 seconds, you may start to feel a little better. There's also, well, there's a lot of mindful ways to deal with your personal stress. We have also the metaphor of an elephant. You can imagine you're driving around just like an elephant would drive in a car. And that means you really allow yourself to sink in the seat, and rather than being wanting to be all the time somewhere else, you simply, yes, good. You got a beautiful smile, just 10 seconds. but of course, there's also the part of interpersonal stress. And I think if we want to stop projecting all our judgments and frustrations on the other people, we have to take radical responsibility for our attitudes. So let's imagine that you're going to work, and instead of driving a car, you would be driving an army tank. And each time when somebody is driving in your way, you have the permission to push a little button, and the road is clear again. Now imagine everybody would have permission to do so. How do you think the road would look like? So, I think it's important to see that how easily we see other people as a threat when we want everything to be our way. And perhaps also it's important to realize that there is no way to happiness. Sometimes we believe that happiness is located in a point in space and time. But then we will keep chasing something we can never reach. That's why sometimes you say happiness is now here or nowhere. So perhaps we have to take this saying also to heart, don't hurry, be happy. And if we stop chasing or running all the time, we won't perceive people as a threat so much anymore. We won't judge so easily. And of course, there will still be people who do not drive the way we want them to drive. But at times, we will not drive the way others want us to drive. We cannot forget that. We all have our imperfect moments. So rather than judging the other all the time, like where did he get his driver's license, and he's driving too fast, and he's driving too small, and he's changing the lane and doesn't put his indicator, and then you have like that old brain reaction, brrr. Yeah. Why would you judge someone when you are in your car? The only result is that you become miserable. So rather than judging the other, why not send your good wishes? Like, may you be happy. Yesterday I was driving, and there was somebody really driving, I think 200 or something. So I sent him the simple wish, may you discover the value of driving safely. And the important thing, it's a wish you send from your compassionate heart, not from your critic. And it's something you can train. This difference between your critical voice and your compassionate voice. Yeah. Of course, at times it may be very difficult to send your wishes. And perhaps a lot of things happened in your life. You had to endure a lot of setbacks. People have been abusing your trust. And you feel like you can't trust anybody. And so really go in that negative, suspicious mindset. And of course, this kind of pain needs our compassion. But at the same time, it's important to realize that we have new situation, new people, and we can choose for a new mindset. So you could simply, as a practice, Just imagine that everybody on the street, but perhaps even here, has good intentions towards you. Just imagine how it would be if you go with that mindset in your life. And it's not about becoming unrealistically positive. It's about avoiding to become unrealistically negative. So, of course, you may still feel sometimes that people really don't have good intentions. And that's even more advanced practice. Then you can really cultivate your generous heart. Because if you really feel like somebody didn't have good intentions, he's probably not very happy. Yeah. Nobody wakes up in the morning and says to himself, "Oh, I'm so perfectly happy. Who will I hurt today?" No. If people who hurt other people, that happens out of their own pain. So, of course, I think we have to remember we are all of us, we are all in it together. Like, nobody likes traffic jams. It can be very stressful at times. Even if you practice mindfulness and you practice your smile and you practice your wishes, can still be. But sometimes when we are in the stress of a traffic jam, we are very self-absorbed and we forget that the other people around us are very stressed as well. So we can include ourselves and others in our wishes. And then we use like words like, "May we be happy," or "May we live in peace," or perhaps the next step, "May we live happy together. May we live in peace together." So it's a little bit my hope that we could really work on this compassionate attitude wherever you are, if you're in the car or if you're in the train or if you get annoyed because you're in the wrong line again. And rather than complaining, just send your wishes to other people complaining. Or send your wishes to people who are in the right lane and say, "Oh, you're lucky. I wish you even more good luck." This is called the heart of shared joy. And I think it's fantastic practice. You try it. You will see. Your heart will love it. So I think this can just contribute to a world with a little bit more, at least tolerance, but respect, love, and compassion. So thank you.